Like a fairyland indeed is the Grand Promenade, $60 million Constitution Mall. Half a mile of unprecedented, breathtaking beauty, framed by Manship's famous sundial. Dominating the mall is Fraser's lofty and heroic figure of George Washington. The father of our country stands in impressive simplicity, flanked by the flags of the original 13 states. Cascading fountains, expansive flower beds, and hundreds of restful shade trees form a scene you'll never forget. Mother Nature vies with master builders and world-renowned sculptors to provide this gorgeous vista. Striking reminder of the pillars of American liberty are the four freedoms: freedom of speech, freedom of assembly, freedom of religion, and freedom of the press. The impressive water curtain of the million-dollar lagoon fountains unveils the Court of Peace and the majestic federal building, home of Uncle Sam's own exhibits. Here, President Roosevelt dedicated the world of tomorrow to peace and freedom. It has played host to 26 million enthralled visitors, king and commoner, great and humble, rich and poor. Highlight of the welcome to President and Potentate is the parade of the Guard of Honor in the Court of Peace. Stirring is the sight of Uncle Sam's picked soldiers, sailors, and Marines swinging past. Foremost in the procession of royalty at the fair, their Britannic Majesties, King George and Queen Elizabeth. The King Emperor and his charming consort, wearing a favorite powder blue, were thrilled by what they saw, just like every visitor. Their regal visit to the imposing British Pavilion has written a chapter in the annals of the fair, which gives the area they traversed an unforgettable aura of royalty. Every hall of the British Commonwealth of Nations reflects the pride of the empire on which the sun never sets. Another beautiful royal pavilion, the Netherlands. For 1940, the building is transformed to house a colorful new display. Modern masterpiece was this artistic Dutch panel of stained glass, picturing Queen Wilhelmina and the achievements of her realm. Czechoslovakia is still very much on the map of the world of tomorrow, just like our sister republics of the Western world. East meets West, where Japan has recreated a colorful historic shrine to house its artistic exhibits. It stands in a quaint exotic garden that truly transports visitors to the land of the rising sun. Nipponese maids in native garb wait to welcome you. Oriental glamour plus. Fair within a fair is the Court of States, a panorama of national progress from Pacific to Atlantic, from Maine to Florida, land of palms and Spanish architecture. In its cathedral-like tower is the world's largest carillon, which chimes in daily concerts on Fountain Lake. The spirit of early America relives in New Jersey's replica of the Revolutionary Barracks of Trenton. Here, New England brings back memories of the era when Yankee clippers dominated the seas as their modern successors dominate the skies. Historic setting that emphasizes the importance of America's trade in the future as in the past. Beautiful flag-bedecked avenues traverse all zones of the fair. You can walk or you can ride in these comfortable buses that carry visitors to every part of the grounds for only 10 cents. One of the garden spots is the Court of Communications. In the background, towering pylons flank the huge communications building with its modernistic murals. It houses the United States Coast Guard and other interesting exhibits. Before all, dashes this modern Pegasus symbolizing speed.